So I was going to talk for about 10 minutes or so on localization and globalization in Windows runtime apps. This is the last session of the ones that are specifically focused on writing Windows runtime XAML apps. So after we finish this one, then we're into the whole set of APIs that are available, whether you're coding in Silverlight or you're coding in Windows runtime XAML. So this is the last one that's specific to this particular flavor of the XAML frameworks. So what we're going to do is talk about global market opportunity, developing a localized app, globalization, and translation. So why do you want to do this? Well, a stupid question, really. Why would you want to globalize and localize your apps? Well, like the store is global, that's a good start. 191 markets. We've got support for 54 languages on in Windows Phone 8.1. There were 50 in Windows Phone 8.0, and in 8.1, we add an additional 4. And then we also need to think about the languages that your app is offered in. If you offer your app only in English, that's only going to cover around 25% of Windows Phone users. These stats are from the middle of 2013, so that might not be completely accurate, but it's give you an indication. So if you add Mandarin and Spanish, that's going to increase your language coverage to around 60%. And if you go the whole hog and add Russian, Italian, Portuguese, and French, you're going to get the majority of all Windows Phone users. But also, you know, you could actually create an app that maybe doesn't do as well as you'd like in some markets, but you could be right up there at the top and really get real good success in other languages if you take the trouble to localize to their language and their currency symbols and date formats, all that kind of good stuff. So the top 15 highest grossest apps in the past, we typically support 8 languages. Also, if you think about the priority markets that you want to offer in, 12 of the top 15 apps are published in 187 or more markets. And China and Latin America download twice as many apps as the US. So, you know, think about the markets you want to localize to, and maybe, you know, it's going to pay off for you to localize. We got some new stuff in, there's a big difference now in the Windows Phone 8.1 devices. So, all 54 of the supported languages, UI languages, will be pre-installed on most phones. There's a difference the way users can handle phones. You can enable multiple languages and sort them by order of preference. You can continue to auto-download language packs and things for text-to-speech, text-to-addition, and speech files to align with the selected languages that you pick. This is different from Windows Phone 8, where phones were shipped in kind of regional blocks, if you like. So you kind of have a Latin American phone and a European phone and a North American phone, this sort of thing. So you'd have certain languages would be included in, but not the whole lot. Whereas now any phone can download can use any of the languages. And to support that, we obviously in the emulator, we've got a lot of... this whole control panel thing that helps you to support that. Oh my goodness, it doesn't like that clicking. Come back. Come back to me. Right, let's try that again. Click, breathe. Got a twitchy emulator here. Right, okay, we're good. Settings, relaxing, okay. scrolling down. There's a lot of settings these days. Shout if you see it.
Language.
Thank you so much, yes. So here we go. We got English, United States. If we want to add language, we can add a language. Let's add Deutschland. There you go. German. We'll add that one on. It needs you to restart the phone, so we can restart the emulator, and it says, see you later. And then it reboots, and we come up in in German. And any of those 54 can be selected like that. And you end up with a list. This is always challenging. I have to carefully pick the language I select, because then what happens is, not for resale, you cannot sell this emulator. There's a funny thing. Go to settings and then, oh gosh, what is settings? You see my problem. Anyway, you get the idea. Yeah. You get the idea. So let's just kill that so I can get one coming back in English. I apologize for my lack of German there. So you kind of get the idea of that. How do you go about developing a localized app? So first of all, you need to determine which languages you want to support. So the way that you specify languages is by using something called a BCP47 language tag. So you specify, languages can be specified both as a kind of a regional language, such as EN, which means English, and then as well as regional variants. So we have EN-US, and the convention is to have lowercase the first bit and then uppercase the second, which is US English. And then the next one is Queen's English, ENGB, and EN Hong Kong, for example. So you've got these different variants in there. So you can provide resources in any ones of those different languages. And then at runtime, Windows takes care of looking at the resources that you've built into your app, looking at the language preferences that the user has selected in the control panel settings, and coming up with the best fit. So it will come up with the best fit for it. So what you need to do is create separate string resources for each, starting with string resources for each locale, each BCP47 code that you want to support. You see in that graphic there, we've got strings for ARSA, DEDE, NUS, and JAJP. But here's the good thing. In the same way as with the images that Matthias showed you, where you don't need to do anything particularly fancy to go and pull a image at the right scale, in a similar way, you don't need to do very much about loading resources. So all you need to do from XAML is specify an X colon UID attribute with a, and what you put in that word greeting that you see there, that's kind of a key into the resources file. And then the text is blank in the XAML, but then it goes to the resource file and it will go and set on that text block. The text property will be set to bonjour if it's a French phone, if it's the phone is set to the French language. And the width of that will be set to 20. So you can actually set any number of properties from the resource file just by using that X colon UID as a key into the resource file. And then you use the key, greeting, dot, and then whatever property you want to set on that. And in code, you can do things as well. So you can have like that farewell au revoir there. You can, in code, you can create a new instance of a resource loader and then call loader.getString and again pass the key into the resource file. And the Windows will just take care of going into the resource file and picking the right one out according to whichever resources it has selected to match the best fit for the user's selected language preference in the control panel. You can also localize files in the manifest. So there's lots of information in the manifest, such as the display name, description, and things that end up on in the store app. And the display name is what you see in the programs list on the phone. So in there, all you need to do is put ms-resource colon, and then what follows it, app display name in this case, again is the key into the resource file. So nice and easy. And all of this is all part of this resource loading that we saw with the images. The resource loading that we saw with the images, you can see there we've got logo.scale180, logo.scale240.png. This is what Matthias was talking about for scaling the scale of images. But you can also have locale dependent images as well. So you can also work these things together. You can have an images, en-us, logo.scale180.png, and to load that in your XAML, you just put /images/logo.png. And Windows will take care of figuring out how to get the scale one and what language one to load. So it's all magic. It makes it really, really easy. So it's just a case of naming things right and putting them in the right folders. Right, a little bit of help with translation, which is the Multilingual App Toolkit, which is an easy-to-use localization tool for, well, it says the Windows Phone SDK, but for the Windows SDK and loads of other SDKs as well. So a great integration into it and really makes it easy to translate stuff. So I'm going to do a little demo for that. So here, I'm going to go to the begin first, and then I'll quickly switch to the end one, just so that we can. I've got my, it's our old friend, the Contoso cookbook. Yay. And the about page, for example, has got a bunch of fields in here. And I've got these magic XUIDs I've added. App name, about page header, version text, all this sort of thing. So all the text that you're seeing on there, sure, in design time we're seeing the English version. And of course I've got a resource file with just the US at the moment, which has got the US English versions for them. And then I can do, I've got in tools and extensions and updates, I've installed the tools, the Multilingual App Toolkit. So you can just go along, you can go online and install this yourself. You can go and find it and then install it. I've installed it. So then, because I've lost my notes, so I'm just going to guess on this. Where do we do that? Let me just find my notes here so I can remember how to do this. Apologies. Okay, so somewhere in these things up here, there's a way of enabling the Multilingual Toolkit. Somebody tell me where this is. Project. On the Tools menu. I couldn't see it before.
No, I didn't. Preemptive.
Oh, that's weird. It's not there. Maybe I need to build. No, that's. Okay. So I've got a glitch here. So there should be on the Tools menu. I enable Multilingual Toolkit, and it ain't there. So that's a bit confusing. Oh, disappointing. So I will try one thing, and then we'll just leave it, which is it's probably an update. It's probably, no, that's CSS stuff. So installed tools. Uninstall and put it back in again. Which it won't allow me to. All right, well, this is officially today's demo that bombed. All right, I'm struggling to. Maybe it doesn't like it. That's kind of weird. Let me open the finished one. Hopefully, it will still be working. It will actually work in the finished one. Because, like all good professionals, I never leave myself open to chance here. So. The multilingual stuff is in here. I can try and open it. No, it's definitely broken.
There is a great demo, if we can't pull it up here, on Channel 9, inside Windows Phone on the Multilingual App Toolkit, 20, 30 minutes, if anybody's interested in going to check it out.
Oh, I got it.
There we go.
I got it, yes, there we go. This is the Multilingual App Toolkit, where you can translate to different things. So I can, see all my context menus are not here. This is a bit disappointing. You mentioned it's very easy to add languages. Trust me, guys, it's really easy to add languages. This is some of the hazards of working with not quite final release software. All right, well, we'll move on. It does honestly make it really easy to handle translations.
Yeah.
The let's look at the French one, open with the multilingual editor. You can see this is the translation and all of the different values in here. But the real cool thing about this is that you can automatically translate against Bing in order to get suggested translations really easily. We'll blog about this point.
I think a fun thing about that is that it uses the Bing Translate for free. Normally, yep. Bing Translate is a paid service, but if you're using it to translate your Windows Phone application using the Multilingual App Toolkit, it's a free service. You can do as many translations as you want to as many languages as you want.
Yep. No, it really doesn't want to play. Okay, we'll move on. There are some good assets for helping you translate stuff, particularly where you've got technical terms, you know. So this terminology lookup, which is this language portal, is really, really useful. You can search and enter an English term or another language and then select a language to translate it for. So things like Windows terminology is really easy for that. You can also download the UI strings if you've got an MSDN subscription. A UI strings glossary is a great cross-reference for standard strings in a computer UI that you can use. Now, finally, globalization, there's a whole bunch of APIs that can help you with other stuff as well, like globalization.calendar to get time zones and work with time zones, and date time formatting. So it's really important with this kind of think about these things as well, formatting dates and times appropriately. Formatting numbers and currencies. So there's loads of number formatting class as well for doing good, appropriate regional formatting for numbers and currencies. All these little things all add up to making a truly world-ready app. Calendars as well. The Windows.globalization.calendar class allows you to work directly on calendar dates and gives you appropriate representations for different regions and cultures. And that, with an unspectacular demo, is the end of that particular module. So that is also the end of the little mini course of the Windows Runtime XAML. So we're just going to dive down into cool stuff like files.
Yay!
And stuff like that in the next session. So we'll be back in a few minutes. How many?
10 minutes.
We're getting the call from the back of the room. Right. So 10 minutes. We'll see you in 10. Thanks a lot.